Blackstone Audio presents We Are All Stardust. Scientists who shaped our world talk about their work, their lives, and what they still want to know. By Stefan Klein. Translated by Ross Benjamin. This book is read by Gildart Jackson, Simon Vance, Kate Redding, and Sean Runnette. Introduction. On the courage to spend a lifetime searching. Science defines our lives as never before. And yet we don't know much about the people who change our world with their research. It can't be that they have nothing to share. Many of the scientists I met for the conversations in this book look back on astonishing life stories. They have unusual interests and think far beyond the horizons of their respective fields. In short, as people, they are just as interesting as the actors, professional athletes, or politicians whose inner lives we hear about in minute detail. Yet, we still tend to picture all scientists as Einstein, the genius who is inept at life and sticks his tongue out at the world. This lingering perception is partly scientists' own doing. They try to deny their personal side. Science aims to be objective. The self is to be kept out of it. In a scientific publication, to use the word I is sacrilege. And because scientists, of course, crave recognition as much as anyone else, they help construct the myth that surrounds them. Scientists may be discouraged from expressing their individual personalities too strongly in their professional world, but they can at least flatter themselves that they are scholars who hover above everyday things. But there's another, deeper reason that the thoughts and feelings of scientists are unknown to the public. Our society views science with tunnel vision. Scientific research is rightly perceived as a source of prosperity. It has brought us effective medications, computers, and thousands of other amenities. The work of scientists in their laboratories is clearly useful, even if we don't always understand it. But in the eyes of most people, it has nothing to do with what really moves us, with the existential questions of our lives. To think that way, however, is to overlook the fact that science is part of our culture, like our books, our music, our movies. From its beginnings, science has explored the mysteries of our existence, and particularly in recent years, scientists have gained many insights that help us see more clearly who we are, where we come from, and what it means to be human. For this book, I have met some of the women and men to whom we owe such insights. With two exceptions, my interviews with scientists from Europe, the United States, India, and Australia took place between 2007 and 2012. I was encountering almost all my subjects for the first time. Usually, I arranged to meet with them on two consecutive days, always in a place of their choosing. Often we spoke in their offices, but we also occasionally conversed on long walks or in restaurants, museums, or their houses. The one thing I demanded in advance from the scientists was time. Generally, our dialogues, some conducted in German, some in English, lasted 5 hours. The interviews collected here are distilled from those conversations, edited and significantly condensed, to include the most interesting passages. All but one first appeared in the magazine supplement to Die Zeit, the German weekly newspaper, and many interviews went on to be included in a prior German edition of this book. These interviews thus took an indirect path to their English language publication here, in many cases after having been translated into German for Die Zeit, and now translated back again. To ensure nothing has been lost in the process, every interview in this book has been reviewed and approved and sometimes lightly updated by the interviewee. For several conversations, I decided to take this opportunity to revisit the original, voluminous transcripts. Working directly from those, I have been able to bring to light many revealing passages not included in the former newspaper versions. All my conversation partners enjoy a worldwide reputation in their fields, and all have made a mark by placing their research in a broader context. They include a winner of the Nobel Prize in Chemistry, who has made a name for himself as a poet, a cosmologist who publicly wagers on the fate of the world in the next decades, and a physiologist.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.